I invite your host to address you. Ladies and gentlemen, Monsieur Arnaud Bamberger, President of the French Chamber of Commerce in Great Britain and Executive Chairman of Cartier UK.
Dear Ambassador, mon cher Bernard, dear Lionel Barber, dear ladies and gentlemen, good evening. On behalf of the largest foreign chamber of commerce in the UK, obviously the French Chamber, I'm pleased to welcome you tonight to our 131st annual gala dinner. And I'm particularly honored to welcome Lionel Barber, who is the editor of the Financial Times, who will address us later after the starter. Lionel, as you may be aware, you are following the steps of other great speakers.
32 years ago, Handicap International was born in refugee camps along the Thai-Cambodian border, actually from a refusal of a generally accepted rule. That was the wisdom of the time. That people in situation of disability should wait.
This partnership between France and the UK today is a strategic one, a very important one, and we are joining our forces, because if we don't do that, we'll disappear in the decades to come. Well, dear friends, as you know and must be all too aware, priority is regularly given now, to the economic diplomacy in France's action abroad today. Tonight, we have the great pleasure and honor of welcoming Lionel Barber, the editor of the Financial Times, who has worked for the FT for 28 years.
First, the enduring benefits of bilateral cooperation. Britain and France remain permanent members of the UN Security Council. We are still regional powers with serious armed forces who have stood shoulder to shoulder in the field from Bosnia to Libya. Second, we should recognize the enduring fact of joint EU membership. Yes, I know that we in Britain, or at least David Cameron, has proposed a referendum on EU membership in 2017, and I'm going to come to that. But for now, we sit as partners around the clothed tables in Brussels and other European destinations.
It has been a great pleasure to hear of that entente tonight. In medieval times, 800 ships sailed from Bordeaux to Britain. They went out with cheese, would you believe, to France. You might believe it now. 20 or 30 years ago, you wouldn't have believed it. But they went out with cheese and stone. That stone still paves the streets of Saint-Emilion. But more than that, the spirit of that link is here. At the end of the 13th century, there was a Lord Mayor of London three times, who was Mayor of Bordeaux as well twice. And that represents in many ways the ancient links when our masters, our political masters, have left us at peace with each other. We have thrived, we have prospered, and above all, we have enjoyed the wines of Bordeaux. And that is one of the great advantages, of course, of the times of peace in which we live, unlike those of many of our ancestors. And I am delighted tonight that you are enjoying again the wines of Saint-Emilion, that the ancient jurisdiction has provided them to cement the links between our two nations.
Well, thank you very much to all of you. I mean, we didn't know what to expect, so it's just a very, very good surprise. But on top of that, we are extremely grateful to the Chamber, the French Chamber of Commerce.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're very fortunate to enjoy the talent, the sounds, the music, and the voice. Put your hands together, please, just for us, Gabrielle Ducomble.
French President.